I'm dying. Can't find her someone to. Hey, man. Hey. All right. What's popping, YouTube? It is your boy, King Chris, and I'm back again with another video. So today, guys, I'm going to be showing you guys my top 10 favorite songs by X. Every time I do a poll on Instagram, everyone's always asking, what is my favorite song by him? And I have a lot of songs that I really do like, and I could possibly have on repeat all day. The songs I'm gonna be showing you guys is the chill / like sad songs, but it's like chill, sad, kind of more mellow, low songs, not the upbeat and uptight songs. So this one is the one I listen to like before I go to sleep, or if I'm just waking up, or like a long car ride. So I'm gonna be showing you guys my top 10. I honestly love these songs. Like, I don't really want to put it on a scale of 1 to 10. I already know my number 1, but I don't want to really put the other ones on a scale of 1 to 10. But if I had to put it on a scale of 1 to 10, this is the scale. So, at number 10, I had to pick this song. I love this song a lot, but I had to pick this one, though, as number 10, because I just needed something to start out. I know my number 1, though, but this is my number 10. This is a song right here. Also, one more thing. I also wanted to give a special shout out to Lyle Hansen for the freaking shirt, man. For the freaking shirt. I love this shirt so much. It says, all rappers going to heaven. No. All rappers go to heaven. Not going. My fault. All rappers go to heaven. I honestly love this shirt. It's so comfortable, and it's like really affordable, and thank you for shipping it to me. And she even sent, hold up. She even sent this. It says, I can't read backwards. It says, thank you for all your support, Chris. XOXO, Lau. I love it. Thank you so much. It means a lot to me. So I keep that right next to my YouTube plaque. And because it really means a lot. So thank you. Shout out to her though. But yeah, back to the song. And one more thing that I noticed that his record label went back to every single song that he's made and they copyrighted it for him. Because, like, as an artist, when you're starting out, obviously you're not going to be able to afford a copyright. Because those shits are low-key expensive. And, like, on top of that, you know, studio time, travel time, like, studio time could be, like, $40 an hour. So, in 3 hours or 2 hours, you can get one song. So, that's $80 for a song. And then on top of that, a copyright, which can be from $50 to $80. So, potentially, you can be, I know you're, like, it's guaranteed you're spending over $100 for a song, even though it's, like, a small little investment. If you want to do music full-time, it's a small investment. But if you're doing it on the side, then the copyright, you know, it can be a little expensive, you feel me? So, he didn't have a lot of songs copyrighted, and now that I'm going back to, like, a few of his songs, a lot of them are copyrighted. So, it's crazy, man, it's crazy. Not the copyright thing, but just everything.
I didn't remember much. I just hit that. It definitely stood out.
I honestly love this song. And the thing is, I found out about this song kind of late. I wasn't really, like, one of the first to, like, really listen to this song. So I think I found out about it, like, last year. It was, and basically, it wasn't even, it was from an edit that I found this song. Like, I love Instagram edits, the Vine edits. I was all about that. I love those type of edits. I love those. So I love the editing community, all of that. But I found this song through an edit, and I enjoyed it ever since then. And I'm glad I found it. I'm glad I did. I mean, eventually I would have found it, but I'm glad I found it as soon as I did back then. So, that was number 10. Number 9, I'm going to have to say, I Spoke to the Devil in Miami. That song is so amazing. It's so fire. It's simple, and it's just, like, well put together. And I love the visuals. Like, I love anime so much. Like, I love the anime visuals that go with it. Oh my god, I don't care. I love the visuals that go with it. This one we got. And these are braids, not dreads. So. Husband broke up, where's the school and hey, all this is recklessness, this world of a pacifism, world of a masochism, all for the man, my lord, I spoke to a bad for me, he said even 7 years, if I gave you one thing you needed, what is this thing I pleaded, my fingers are strong, taking about these smiles and tells me, what you crave is still yours, but what I crave is all mine. I honestly love this song so much. Like, honestly, I think this song is so fire, bro. Like, this song, it gives me, like, that chill, kind of laid-back type of vibe. Like, honestly, this song means a lot to me. And it's just, like, really well, bro. X was, like, a whole genius, and I'm just glad he made this song. All right, so at number 8, I have You're Thinking Too Much, Stop It. I feel like a lot of people really do sleep on this song. I love this song so much, and it's just the vibe and everything is just there. I mean, I do listen to the slowed versions and the remixes of, like, of his songs, but just, I love the way he samples his music. I love the samples, like, but this is definitely number 8. But yeah, for people who haven't heard this song yet, it's called You're Thinking Too Much, Stop It. This girl, yeah. Number 30 on the 108, drinking that you do a song with it like this girl. Yeah, that I ate bait like a hurricane. I need to cuss it out, really got that pussy done for you, really dumb. Eating good, so what's heartbreak? Are you thinking about is that pussy feel me done? I like that. So I touch you, but it's like that. I found this song kinda late. Like real late. I found it this year, maybe like March, April-ish. And honestly, if I just know for a fact, if he samples somebody's vocals in the beginning of a song, fire. Don't even need to listen to the rest of it. Just know it's going to be fire. And this song, I feel like it's really, really slept on. So not, it hasn't been brought to the mainstream media, but I do really like this song a lot, and I feel like more people should, like, kind of appreciate it more, because I feel this song really gives me those good vibes. That was number 8, though. My number 7, I'm gonna have to say Let's Pretend We're Numb. I'm gonna have to say that. That song is absolutely fire, a straight banger. And I'm telling you, these. Hold on, I'm gonna let them speak. Don't pretend to be okay when you're not okay. Don't pretend to be happy when you're sad.
Girl, I know you think about it almost every day. Dude, this ain't half this love we had. Trust was good, I should have held you close. Should have kept you warm. And when the rain is falling, when the room you call, don't credit God, you rather try your call. Don't cry, pretend it don't hurt.
I won't stomp
my feet in the rage, my nigga, I'm no champ.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Damn. That was my number 7. I love that song. Honestly, I feel like it could be number 3, but I'm just gonna leave it at number 7. But I honestly do love this song. I found out about it maybe like a couple months after it released the first time. So yeah, this song is just straight fire. It's absolutely fire. Okay, so for the next song, I'm gonna have to say it's more of a more recent song. I feel like people only pay attention to like the top 3 in this album, 17. But I like this song. It's called Carry On. I'm gonna say that one was my number 6. That one was my number 6 song. It's so chill. The vibe is there. Shiloh really did an amazing job. I don't know where she's at, but she absolutely killed it. And this song is just so mellow. So like, if you're looking for a vibe and you just want to relax, just put this song on. But number 6, Carry On. Hold up. Oh man, got me some gushers. My bad, it's the king size. Yup. Yeah. All right, go ahead.
Trapped in the concept, falsely accused, misused. And slap, bitch, I'm hoping you fucking rest in peace. I can't seem to shake this fucking feeling in my.
Sorry for the free ASMR. I'm sorry, I didn't eat yet. Hold up, bruh. This joint not opening. I'm getting a little frustrated. Like, all right, got it. All right, let's go back. So that was number 6. Yeah, that was number 6. I absolutely love that song. I just feel like that song's a little bit slept on. But on number 5, it was in the Question Mark album. Absolutely love this song. So yeah, this is number 5. He's trying to snap him. People. Okay, that was number 5. The next one, number 4, I'm gonna say is gonna be Numb, which was in his most recent album. This song is straight fire though. I honestly love this song. It gives me my own, like, it helps me think, you know? Okay. That was number 4. My number 3, it's a little bit more, I mean, it's more known than I'm gonna say the rest of them, but this one is one of my top. This is number four. Yeah, I'm tripping. This is number four right now. This is number four. I love this song. And everyone should know it. Everyone should know it. If you really supported him and you know me, you know that I would actually love this song. And you should be able to know this song. Sing it with me. I'm gonna cut this. And honestly, this is one of those songs that, like, this is, like, one of those songs I really do listen to when I'm feeling alone. Like, even before he passed away, this is, like, just one of those songs that, like, if you're really feeling alone, this is, like, one of the songs that I listen to. But, as we get closer to my one, I'm gonna start adding a little bit more side notes and, like, kind of, like, how I really came about those songs and how, like, those songs really do make me feel, because, like, everyone has that one song that makes you feel some type of way, and he made one of those songs that makes me feel some type of way. So we'll get into that. And, you know, this was one of those songs that I wish came out at an earlier time, because this was exactly what I needed, but it didn't come out around the time, like, you know, where, like, I really needed it at that certain moment. Like, I needed something or some type of comfort at that moment, you know. The song, it came out August 25th of last year. It came out last year. Because I remember I'm Dante reacting to it. Yeah. So that time I was really good. You know, mentally I was okay. But this was just like one of those things, like, oh my God, I wish it would have came out earlier. This song's so amazing, and it would have helped a whole lot of people. It's not like it's still helping a lot of people, but it's like one of those songs I'm just like, dang. I was really at an all-time low. If this song was there, it would have helped so much in the process. But anyway, man. Time for number... What is this? Number three? Yeah, it's number three. This song is number three. And I absolutely love this song. You guys should know this one, too. And it's really, really short.
I'm feel pain when I'm feeling love. Change hoes like clothes, I can get attached. Cause these hoes fast, hold us like lit matches. I've been feeling really lost, looking all attached. Nigga really wanna die in the nighttime. Nigga really wanna die in the nighttime.
Oh my God, I absolutely love that song. That was number three. I don't really have much backstory to that one. I don't know, I just like that one more. I just like that one more than that song for it. Cause like, I think it's more, has more of a melody to it. I just like the melody of it, you know what I mean? I like that it has meaning in it, and, you know, I just like everything, the way he conformed it. It's just, I can't really put it into words right now. But this one, you guys should know, is like my second favorite because, well, it is my intro. It is my YouTube intro. You guys should know this song. Most of you guys should know this song at least. This song is just a straight banger, and it has Trippy Red on it. This was before when he started acting like, ooh, all weird and everything. This is when everything was just cool in the rap game. Everything was so good then. Oh. Little side note, this is also my ringtone. this is really my second favorite song. But this is also my ringtone, just saying. I love that part. I love that little part. This song, it means honestly, like, this song is it's my number two, and it's also my ringtone. It used to be my alarm about, like, last year when it came out. Mom, Mom, leave me alone. I'm recording a video. Anyway, cut that. Anyway, so this is, like, one of my favorite songs. It used to be my alarm back then, and it's my ringtone now, and honestly, this song just makes me happy. The vibe is there, and, you know, especially when, because the crazy part is, X originally didn't like the beat. Originally, he didn't even like the beat, you know, and Trippy sent it to X. He didn't like it, and then Trippy did his part, sent it back to X. He started banging with it, and then that's when, you know, X kind of put in his own thing. So I just love how, I kind of really love the backstory to it. And now, to my number one song. This song, this song is for everyone who keeps on asking me, what is my favorite X song? What is the first X song that I heard? This answers two questions that I get commonly asked. Especially when I do the Instagram Q&A, like mini Q&A on Instagram. This question always comes up. What is my favorite X song? What is the first X song I heard? So, this answers both of them. And if you don't follow me on Instagram, link will be in the description. Make sure you do. And it will be also in the pinned comment. So, make sure you follow me on Instagram. But, oh wait, almost clicked the extended version. But, basically, okay, so anyway, my number one song is I Don't Want to Do This Anymore. It was the first song that I ever heard, and it's my favorite song. This song means so, 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 so much to me. I'm just going to let it rock, and then I'm going to give you the backstory behind it. Okay, so that's the song, I Don't Want to Do This Anymore. That is my number one song. always, and it will always be. Nothing will change it ever. That, like, even above all songs that will come out in the future, this is my number one song that will always be there. Because, like, it was a point in my life where, like, I lost myself. This was 2 years ago. It was, like, 2 or 3 years ago. That was, like, my all-time low in life. You know, my principal at my old school, she intended to make me miserable just from the get-go. And this, I didn't have like a bad history with her. Like this, I was a new student, and with time, things just got worse and worse over time. And even though I was always optimistic, more and more, I would just become more depressed and more upset and more miserable. Like every day would be in black and white and all gray. I wouldn't see the colors of the day anymore. I'm not saying I went colorblind. You know what I mean, metaphorically. I was just so miserable. I was really, really miserable. And, you know, it's different when you have just, you're miserable at school and then you go home and you get to do whatever you want. No, it wasn't like that for me. My principal, she would try to get me involved in things I wasn't really involved in. So, like, one time there was, like, a fight or whatever. I wasn't even a part of it. I wasn't a part of it physically, but that's it. Yeah, but it's not my business though. You feel me? It's not my business. So the people who actually were in the fight, they got suspended for one day. I ended up getting suspended for 9 days, and you know, being out of school, you miss a lot. So my grades were obviously going down. There wasn't really much I could do about it because we had laptops that they gave us. So they kicked me out of this thing called Schoology where we like you do all our classes and stuff. So they locked me out of my Schoology, so I couldn't turn in work, can't do homework, can't do classwork, can't do anything. I can't look over the lessons. So everything for those 9 days that I missed, and I'm not talking 9 days, so a week of school. No, I'm talking 9 school days. That's almost 2 weeks. 2 weeks, no work. So my grades were going down. Parents were angry. So every day would just be full of misery. School would be miserable. Home would be miserable. It was terrible. It was frustrating. It was just a bunch of misery and sadness, and I couldn't. And it felt like every day was just like, you know, a routine, a constant routine. Wake up, brush my teeth, take a shower, get dressed, get on the bus, go to a miserable, depressing school, get back on the bus, do homework, brush my teeth, take a shower, go to sleep, same thing over and over again. And it got to the point where like, I couldn't take it anymore. It's because people can handle things differently. What I may handle, you might not be able to handle. But what you may be able to handle, I might not be able to. Like, life is really all about perspective or perception. I think that's the same thing. But what I was going through was beyond me. It was really, really beyond me. Like, and there was real days where like I just wish I didn't wake up. But if I didn't, I wouldn't be here right now. And I know life can be really, really hard. It can get real, real hard, and things can be really, really shitty. But you just gotta be optimistic and know that this is only temporary. Things will get better. And I told myself, no, things are not gonna get better, because like every day, every single day, I would hope for things to get better, but it's just like things just got worse and worse and worse, and I was at my all-time low because I felt like nobody understood. And then, and at least, like if I told people what I would go through, at least mentally, nobody would understand. Nobody. And that's why I talk to you guys more than anybody else, because like I said, nobody would understand. I had three real friends at that school, and then one by one they left because they were tired of the same BS. And then I ended up feeling alone. I was alone all the time. I would isolate myself because I felt alone. But if I'm feeling alone, shouldn't I be with others? Yeah, that's a good argument. But I wasn't on the same time as they were. I wasn't on the same type of mentality. And that's really how I started YouTube, because I was alone. Like, honestly, if you saw me the way I was in school and then you saw me back then when I was on YouTube, you would think there were two different people. And honestly, this song really helped me. It really put me into a better place. It put me into a positive place. Like, I would have this song on repeat. I would have this song on a loop. This song really does mean a lot to me. And it was the first song that I've heard. No. Yeah, it was the first song that I've heard. And it really got me out of that slump. I would grab my little laptop, go into the corner by myself, start going on my Google Drive, jotting down ideas, skit ideas, video ideas, all types of ideas I should do. I would write lyrics. I would write lyrics on my Google Doc. I still have some here. I would write all of that. Whether I had money to eat or not, I was being in that corner just by myself. And anybody that I went to school with will remember that, because they would just pass me by and they would walk and they would look at me. Didn't say it. Not too many people said anything. I remember there was a few from time to time, but not too many would say anything to me. They would just walk, look at me, not say a word. So that's why when I say this will forever be my number one and my favorite song, it really helped me a lot. And it really, like, just a thing. And I'm gonna use this analogy because a lot of people ask me around me, like, why do I always play this song? You know how little kids always carry, like, or always feel attached to that teddy bear or that blankie or this doll or some type of inanimate object? That's how this song is like to me. This song is like my teddy bear, or it's like that little blanket where I can feel a sense of comfort. So that's really what it is. Yeah. So now you guys know. That's just the reality of it. It is what it is. But, hey man, I'm not trying to be depressing. Like, come on. Smile a little bit. Yes, just smile a little bit. But yeah. This is my top 10 favorite songs. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I think I'm gonna be double uploading today. So hey, stay tuned for that. But yeah, these are my top 10. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. It's at Chris Agbana Jr. Yeah, man. And it will also be link is in the description. I don't really use Twitter, so I'm not gonna plug it in. So make sure you follow me on Instagram though. That's where I really do everything. And make sure you add me on Snapchat. Actually, I don't really respond to DMs a lot on Instagram, but Snapchat, I always respond to Snapchat. Like literally 99.9% of the time I respond to Snapchat. So if you ever just want someone to talk to, or you ever need a friend, or you're just feeling alone, just hit me up on Snapchat, because honestly, that's where I really do respond. So yeah, man. And if you're new, make sure you subscribe, make sure you like the video, and I'll see you next time. Hey.